Okay, folks, this is rather plain Jane. Fucking boring, but can we make it into something interesting, folks? That is the question we're going to answer in a moment, folks. Let's see how we go.
Yep, sometimes the most shittiest originals often turn out to be the most, really the best. So hopefully this one, we can make it into a treat. Even though it looks boring. Okay, let's see what this dull one is. It is, looks, I think it's a tablecloth, and it's made out of that, some kind of, it's like a form of coarse canvas, like canvas material, but it's shithouse. It's fucking boring for this kind of use, but we're going to try our best by scrunching it up and making it into something a lot more presentable as an artwork. So we're going to scrunch it and hold it. Because I have, it's really not the type of material that's going to keep itself together. Actually, it does quite more than I thought. And that's come up looking really quite interesting. It's a bit large. I do think we could scrunch it up further. It's not very interesting, as I said. It's really plain Jane material, folks. So I'm going to have to really rip in and scrunch it up. Really big. A big scrunch up. Yeah, that looks better. Still looks a bit boring. Looks like there's not much to it. Tell you what we're going to do with this piece, folks. It's really dull and fucking boring, to say the least. Bit like the rhyme I've made, which says painting and drawing is boring, because my dad does not appreciate my photocopier art. He thinks to be a successful artist, which is more important than being passionate to him, you have to do something a little bit more mainstream, and that is painting and drawing. But I don't have any passion or talent either way to do it. I don't have passion, I don't have talent, I don't have either. So there's no point in me taking up painting and drawing. You know, that it's not my talent, it's not got my soul. It has no, I have no connection to painting and drawing. It's really just not my thing, but I know my dad reckons that it's more conducive to success. And Dad, I know Dad's seen me working with my photocopier art for many years. He's seen how it appears to have failed, that it's not something that's really worth anything, and he just doesn't seem to think that there's any potential for it. I know I did something really stupid when I was young. I had the opportunity to shine as an artist back in 1992, and I had access to my friend and my partner Luigi, who could have promoted me as an artist and put me in touch with the right connections. But I failed and I gave up being a photocopier artist. I didn't feel it was worth anything. I had a lot of problems going on in my head. I had a lot of worries, I had a lot of fears, and I wasn't thinking straight, folks. And I gave it up, And that's why it looks so bad, because when I gave up photocopy art, it disappeared. First it disappeared off the Australian shore, and then it just receded to other countries like Germany and stuff like that. And basically it's not there in Australia anymore. So basically my dad has never seen anything successful come from it. So he hasn't seen it, even though it was my mistake that I decided to give it up when I did. And he doesn't get it. You know, you can't explain it to him. You could go blue in the face and pass out, and he'd still he'll still believe what he believes, and that is that there's something wrong with this, that there's something wrong with being a photocopier artist, that there is something wrong with it, folks, something inherently foolish about it. If you're going to enlarge it on the horizontal, I think we need to maybe cut it there. It looks a bit too, yeah. But basically, yeah, my dad and also my brother, they both are against my art. They're perhaps two of my worst critics. Very unfortunate to have family members as my worst critics, to not have them believe in me. I have to believe in myself, folks. That's all I've got. When I was young, I never believed in myself. And that was the big mistake. One of the big mistakes, not believing in myself. Believing in what the idiots at school and the people at church were telling me, making me feel bad about myself. And I really feel so angry that I let them influence me like this, you know? And, you know, hatred breeds hatred. If you hate yourself, the bitches aren't going to feel sorry for you. The bitches at school that tease and bully you, they're not going to feel sorry if you start doing what they wanted you to do, to hate upon yourself. They're not going to fucking want to pull back what they're saying, even though you think they might feel sorry for you. The fact of the matter is they didn't. They just took it as more reason to egg them on to make life a misery for people like myself. So don't allow the bitches under any circumstances to influence you. Don't believe that you're a loser when someone tells you you're a fucking loser. You don't listen to that shit. You fucking do what you're good at, what you're passionate about, and then the bitches will have nothing else to say. If I hadn't known that when I was young, you know, if I hadn't known that, if I had been with Luigi and love could have conquered all. I never let love conquer all. I just let myself be hateful, and I became a hater. So, you know, really, these haters really want you to fall. They want you to fucking feel bad. They don't want to feel sorry for you just because you're crying in your beard and you're saying, I suck, because they say you suck. And then that's what they want. And the people at church who were snobby and thought they were better than you and treated you like you're a fucking piece of shit. I had some good people at church as well, lots of good people, but there were a lot of bad people who influenced me badly. And I never got to, I didn't believe in myself. So I call these people from church and school, schoolies and churchies. And these people just fucked up my head, and I let them have it by not doing my art and not being with Luigi, not being in my happy zone. So you have to fucking prove the bitches wrong. Don't retaliate, don't fight them if you can avoid it. Just try to fucking do what you're passionate about. Excel, do good, do well, and the bitches will fucking have nothing else to say. The bitches will leave you alone then. So you got to fucking... And even if they don't leave you alone, you don't feel so fucking bad about it, and you can just laugh in their face because they're fucking lowly little shitheads who are not succeeding themselves. It's only when you fail that they've walked all over you and succeeded to kick you while you're down. And don't let them have it. Just be yourselves, folks. Don't fucking try to be a stupid, a non-existent person. I can't do that. My dad and my brother want me to be normal. They want me to be normal. No, I can't be normal. That's not me. I can't be normal. Yeah, Dad. Yes, Stephen. I can't be normal, so I'm not going to be fucking normal. I'm going to fucking hate you all till you fucking apologise on the Channel 9 6 o'clock news, bitches. And I don't care, Dad. You've got heart problems. You're in and out of hospital. I don't want you to die, but I want you to fucking apologise so I can talk to you and say goodbye before you're dead. Before you die, Dad, because I know you don't have much time to live, and I need Channel 9 to fucking tell me to play my stuff, should I say, to play my stuff, because I really want to get in touch with you, Dad, and not fucking have you die on me because you picked a dumb argument with me and I fought back and I killed you with my words because you just got angry yourself and you ended up dying of your blood pressure would have shot up. I'm not going to see you because it will happen and I won't, I don't want to fucking kill you, Dad, accidentally. I don't want to kill you accidentally, Dad, with my rage because you don't want to be nice to me. You don't want to treat me with respect and let me be me for a change. Let me be myself, not this fucking normal shit that you've tried to impose upon me since I was little. You know, I can't be normal, Dad. I can't be normal, Stephen. I can't be normal for both of yous. I can't be normal. You know, I'm sorry. I wanted to be normal when I was young, and that was the big mistake. That was another mistake. I wanted to be normal when I was back in 1992 because I thought no one wanted to love me and relate to me. And I thought Luigi had someone else or that I didn't deserve him or something. You know, and I really don't want to hold this grudge forever, but you fucking Dad and Stephen, you're so obsessed with being normal. It's ridiculous. It's unreasonable. You know, why can't you just see that? Why can't you just allow me to be me for fucking first time? I can't talk to either of yous because you fucking treat me like shit. You treat me like I'm a piece of junk, like you think you know it all. You're fucking Mr. Rights. And you're not. Enough of that, folks. We'll just show this piece of artwork. So I think now we've turned this bland piece of shit into something nice. And it's up to you, Channel 9. I want this family feud to be resolved. I want to make money as an artist. I don't want to be on Centrelink and relying on the taxpayer for my fucking survival. I don't want to have to live in social housing. I don't want to have to be a low life. I want to be fucking rich and I want to be famous. I want to make a difference. I want to give back to the taxpayer what I've taken. I really need the airtime that you've got for me. I need that airtime to put the past behind me, to get in touch with Luigi and to marry and to be happy. I'm 51, so I need your help. It's up to you, Channel 9. My dad's dying. He's going in and out of hospital. My mum told me, so I can't have him die on me like that. We must be resolved. We must forgive each other before Dad passes. And I want my brother to be my brother as well. And my mum, she's always worried about me, so I need her to be on board as well and to help have her life made nice and happy because she's miserable because of me, okay, because of my past. I've got to put the past behind me. I need your help, Channel 9. Only you can do it. I can't go any further. I just make my fucking videos, make my art, and hope the fuck you do play my material. So anyway, enough of that, folks. There's my piece. I think we can now call this demo quits.